Hey everyone, it's Dale here again. Hope you're having a great day. Today we're going to create this rounded bar chart animation, which looks super awesome. Let's check it out. Okay, so before we start, we're going to set up our guides. So we'll go to View and turn on our guides. Then we'll right click and we're going to format the background and we're going to choose light gray as our background today. Beautiful. Now we're going to insert a 3 centimeter circle. Oh, that was close. And I'll align it to this center line, roughly about there. And we're going to use this to show the percentage as well. So we're going to just type the percentage symbol in and we'll change the font size. So we'll come home. We'll change the font to Montserrat semi-bold and we'll change the size to 18. Beautiful. Next, we're going to add a shadow. So we'll come up to our format shape, go to effects, and we'll choose the offset bottom shadow. We'll change it to dark gray and increase the transparency to 80%. And we'll increase the blur to 5%. Perfect. Now we'll duplicate the circle by pushing Ctrl D. We'll move this other one along. And once we have it in position, we can push Ctrl D 3 more times and it'll match the locations for us. Now we want to align and distribute these properly. So what we'll do, we'll move this right circle just to the left a bit until the guides come up to say that it matches the same width as the other one. Then we'll select them all, come to Arrange, Align, and we'll distribute horizontally. Fantastic. Next, we're going to change all of the colors to the same colors I have here. So purple, blue, yellow, and orange. So I'll quickly do that. So I'll right click, go to Fill, choose purple, and I'll keep working along. Perfect. Now what we'll do, we're going to duplicate this slide, so we'll click on the slide, hold down Ctrl D to duplicate, and then we're going to draw in a rectangle. And we want to draw it to this middle line here. So draw it to the full length of the slide, and we're going to set the height to 4.5 centimeters. And we'll just make sure it snaps to that middle part there. Perfect. What this rectangle is going to be is a mask. So when the bottoms of these columns come up, this will be used to hide it. So with this rectangle selected, hold down Control and then drag over the other ones to select them and then go to Merge Shapes and we'll subtract. Now hold down Shift and we'll just align that to the bottom of the slide. And what we'll do, we'll come back to that later. So that's ready to go. Come back to this slide and now we need to draw in a rounded rectangle. So come up here and we're going to draw it. Don't worry about the width yet. We'll fix that up in a moment. We'll grab this yellow selected thing and we'll move it to the right until you get a perfect circle. Perfect. Now we're going to change the width to 3 centimeters so it matches the width of the circles. And we'll change the height to 14 centimeters. Great. Now we want to mimic this gradient that's happening here. So we'll go to Gradient Fill. And we'll make this first one pink. And we want the transparency to be 60% for the top. And we'll make the other side pink as well. And we'll leave that solid. Let's align that perfectly so it snaps to the top of the circle. Then hold down Ctrl D to duplicate and drag the next one perfectly in line with the next circle. And once we've done that, you can hold Ctrl D 3 more times and I'll place the other ones in the right spots for you. Now I'm going to change the colors of the gradients to match these circles above them. What I'll do first is I'll select these 4 shapes and I'll right click and I'll send them to the back. Great. So I'll change this one to purple. I'll set the transparency to 60% and the bottom to purple. I'll change the other ones as well, so I'll be right back. All right, it's really looking good now. So what we'll do, we'll go back to the other slide and we'll take our shape that we took before and we'll just copy that. Come in here and we'll just paste it into place. We'll right click it and we'll change the fill to the same color we used for the background. I could also use the slide background filter if I wanted. Beautiful. Next, I'll select all of these shapes. Hold down shift so we keep them aligned and we'll just drag them down until the circles snap into their spots. Perfect. Now I want to put in a title at the top. I also want to keep things aligned. So this shape here is 4.5 centimeters. So we'll put in another block at the top and we'll drag it across using the rectangle and we'll make this 4.5 centimeters as well. We'll change it to the slide background fill and we're just going to type in a title percentage by year. Great. We'll go home and I'm going to choose this sort of gray here and I'll change the font to Montserrat Semi-Bold. Also want to put some years under here, so I'm going to make this from 2017 through to 2021. So I'll just grab a text box and I'll type in 2017. Choose the same gray, Montserrat Semi-Bold, and we'll center that. And we might just reduce that size down a bit to about 16. Perfect. Now drag that down until you see it snap there right to the middle. And then we're going to duplicate that. So press down Control D, duplicate, and drag this one perfectly in position. And once you've done that, once again, press Control D two more times and the others will go perfectly in place. And I'll just change these years. So I'll be back in a sec. Great. Now what I'll do is I'll get rid of this slide because we don't need it anymore. And now we can start looking at putting our percentages in and moving this around. So we're going to start by clicking here and just typing for 90%. We can enter anything. So I'll just enter some numbers along. Now what we want to do now is group these shapes. So I'll just select both of these and hold down Control G and group. Same thing here, and we'll keep working along. Great. And now if I slide this up, you can see we get our effect. That's great. But if we want to know roughly where we want these to slide to, a really good trick is to measure the distance between this box up here and this box here. And that'll be our region. So what we'll do, I'm just going to draw in a rectangle and I'm going to use the top of the circles to be the top of the measurement. So that'd be zero and I'm going to slide this all the way until it hits the box, which will be 100%. Now this height is 8.5 centimeters. So I want to divide this into 10. So I'm just going to make this 0.85 centimeters. Great. And I'll just slide this down until it snaps with the top of the circle. Press Control D to duplicate. Slide it to the top of that square. Each of these represent 10%, so I need 8 more. So I'll push Control D 8 more times. Great. Select them all. Remove the fill. Just leave it to white, that's fine. And we'll just give it an outline. Now I'm just going to zoom out a bit. I'm going to select all of these, and I'm just going to slide them off the slide. And what these do, if I slide this up, you'll start to see that you snap to these lines. That means you're not guessing where the bar charts need to go to. It's actually a bit more measured and more consistent. All right, let's get morphing. So I'm going to select this slide. And I'm going to push Control D to duplicate it. And on this second slide, we can actually move these up. So I'm just going to hold down Shift so I keep it aligned. And I'm going to slide this up until I see it snap with the 90% there. Perfect. And the same with 40%, which will align perfectly with that one. 55%, about halfway, and then I'll just bring it up roughly about another half. And I'll do 30% and 80%. You can see how handy it is to have these guides at the side. They're very helpful. Now we'll select both slides, and we're going to change the transition to morph. And we'll just decrease the duration to 1.25 seconds. All right, so there's only one more thing to do. We just want to hide these numbers so they don't display until they animate in. So what we're going to do is select that shape and we'll just change the color to match the background. And we'll do that for each of these as well. Let's go check it out. That looks fantastic. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed watching this video today. And if you really liked it, just hit that thumbs up button for me. And if you'd like to see some more videos, make sure you click the subscribe button as well so you don't miss out. As always, I've provided the free download link in the description area below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. See ya.